Hello, everybody, and welcome once again to another edition of Inside the Headset. Here we are, week four, game five, and it's a busy Rutherford County week. It's Wednesday afternoon, and we're with the head coach of the Seagull Stars, Greg Wyatt. Coach, you got a big one coming up, but let's talk about your last one, and that is you went down to Ooltewah to take on the Owls, and I understood from the radio show on Saturday. Was there anything else that came out of the film after you had a chance to review it or dissect it a little bit more closely other than the performance of the Seagull Stars and coming away with the win on Friday night?
No, I mean, you go dissect film and you try to find things to work on all the time. We're continually trying to get our football team better. You got to worry about your opponent every week, but you also got to worry about your football team and making sure you're getting them the best that you can get them, and that's what we've done.
Okay. With that, you're heading into a game. We've got one tomorrow night, and then we're going to have one. You guys will be on center stage Friday night, Siegel and Riverdale. Talk a little bit about where you are right now as far as injuries.
We're not in bad shape. We lost our starting center 2 weeks ago. That's about the only major injury that we've got as far as
nicks and bruises.
Yeah, we've got a lot of nicks and bruises like everybody else, but other than that, I mean, we're in pretty decent shape.
Good, good. Be a big crowd here. I know. I did talk to your opponent yesterday. He still wants your gate. So I mean, he'd like to have a piece of it if you give it to him. But what's it take to beat the Riverdale Warriors? They're 4-0. You're 4-0. Both of you have had a really good start in the season. But yet, I know you and I know him. And you know, you still would have liked to have a little bit more of a challenge before you hit this game. But talk a little bit about what's it take to beat the Riverdale Warriors.
You've got to be disciplined. You've got to be disciplined to beat them. They do some things that if you don't pay attention and you don't stay on your reads and keys, they'll make you look bad. You're going to have to play hard for 48 minutes because they've got a good football team. They've got speed and size up front. So the biggest thing that we're trying to key on is trying to be disciplined.
Well, they're going to run it, you're going to run it, and they're going to throw it, and you're going to throw it. And then the big question is I think it's the defense, because I think both of you can put points on the board, but at the one point, don't you think defensive somewhere is going to come into the game as well as special teams?
Yeah, I mean,
you all seem to have a good special team package.
We think so. I mean, we've done a pretty good job. We're proud of the kids and things like that. Defensively, we've got to play discipline, and it's probably going to come down to defense when it all comes said and done.
Well, we're all looking forward to coming out here on Friday night. I'll be here and everything, and I did want to say I was very proud to hear that Rutherford County kids went down to Chattanooga and represented our area well. I heard you speaking on the radio about them going to visit the aquarium, and I appreciate you, Coach, letting kids do something that maybe normally they may not have it, like you said. They may not have a chance, and, boy, they're going to get one Friday night. So we're going to find out what you're made of Friday night. That's what I coached with Coach Haylock and even Coach McDaniel and Coach Ed Owens just an hour ago. I said, you're going to find out a lot after Friday night. Your kids are going to grow up. Win, lose, or draw, you're going to give after Friday night.
Yeah, we're going to find out what kind of metal we're made of, It's a great game, but anytime that you play in a district, it's usually going to be those type of games. So,
you love it.
I love competing in this district because the players are so good, the coaches are so good, and one of the biggest things is that we're going to find out what we're made of on Friday night, and we get to adjust from there. This isn't a make or break type of game, but it puts
it's
you a great, in the driver's
it's great
seat.
Car. It's yeah. a great car game that lets you know how far I can test because you eventually could possibly see them or you will see another high-powered offense or high-caliber team later on down the road.
Sure,
provided. Because right now, stage set, if the wheels don't fall off the wagon, Coach, both of you are going to be in the playoff mix somewhere and get a ticket for postseason.
We hope so. There's still a lot of football left to be played, but yeah, we're hoping so.
I'm looking forward to it. And well, let's gather up and support the Seagull Stars, one of their home games, so they'll be looking forward to capturing that gate. Come on out and support them. That'll be at 7 o'clock. Gang, tomorrow night, 7 o'clock over at Oakland. We'll be at that one. And then Friday night, right here, Riverdale Warriors, Seagull Stars. Y'all come out and support 7 AAA football. We'll see you there.